Malaysia's exports of processed food to OIC countries increased from 1.62 billion ringgit in 2004 to 3.94 billion ringgit in 2008. Although there was a decline in 2009 due to the impact of the world recession, I am confident the growth trend will resume.
Assalamualaikum, greetings everybody. I am Wardina Safiyah, your host, and you are watching Halal World. Now, in today's episode, we shall be looking at the halal food and beverage industry. Now, some say the food and beverage industry is indeed the main business, the core business of this whole halal industry. Gone are the days where we would produce or grow our food requirements individually or even locally. As the population increase, needs and nations will import food products from all over the world. Now, unfortunately, food products imported, especially from the West, often fail to pass halal guidelines stipulated under the Islamic law. Muslim consumers often raise many concerns with regards to their food product, like where did the source come from, what was the procedure used, safety and cleanliness, for example. And with the increase of the Muslim population, it is therefore of great importance that the halal food industry develop itself to be seen as reliable and to produce good quality materials and food products that will earn the trust of Muslims and non-Muslims alike. In our first segment, we will outline and also give you a clear indication of what halal food actually is.
In Islam, food is divided into three categories: halal or permitted, haram or prohibited, and makruh or disapproved. However, in the instance when one is not able to categorize the food product under the three categories mentioned, then it is classified as mashbu or suspicious. As an assurance that a particular product is halal, a halal certification will be issued, but only to those who seek.
In Islam, basically things are originally permissible. This is in accordance with the Islamic legal maxim, which says that al-aslu fil ashya al-ibaha. It means that things are originally permissible, unless when there is a specific text speaks about that thing. So the original status of the permissibility will become non-permissible. Another requirement for the halal food, it must be good and pure, as I said earlier. Good and pure here, of course, in accordance with Islamic perspective, not in accordance with the perspective of any other views other than Islam. So it necessarily, it must follow the requirement of Sharia in order to become good and pure.
Malaysia, seen as a country where halal food and beverage can easily be obtained in every nook and corner, is enjoying a steady influx of tourist arrivals. We asked them on their perception of the halal food available in Malaysia.
Even the food, the Islamic food, most of the food, I can't say the all of the food, but you know, most of the food are halal. I mean, when I say Islamic food, non-alcohol, and as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam recommend us about it.
The general rule is that everything in Malaysia is halal because the majority of the population is Muslim. So, and we also find that in grocery stores or somewhere, if something is not halal, it is clearly marked that this is a non-halal section. So, it is for people whose priority is following a halal lifestyle, then I think Malaysia is a good place.
awareness and observance of halal has been the highest within the food and beverage sector, making the halal compliance in this area to be of great importance. Halal requirements must be followed at all stages of the production and supply chain, including procurement of raw materials and ingredients, logistics and transportation, and wrapping and labeling. What is the best way to ensure that there is no interruption in the halal food supply chain?
The short answer to this question is that there should be steady supply in order to ensure there's no interruption. So the supply must be consistent, must be of high quality, and in order to sustain the flow of this halal food. Secondly, in order to ensure there's no interruption, is that strict compliance to standards, process and procedures. Monitoring is also important, as well as enforcement of guidelines. HDC has been set up to be the developmental organization or developmental agency under MITI to develop the national halal industry in an integrated and comprehensive manner. HDC has been tasked to ensure an integrated and comprehensive development of this industry. Some of the key focus areas is to lead the development of halal standards, direct the coordinate and the development of the halal industry, manage capacity building, support investment. HDC's role here is to create the best possible environment, the conducive environment, to ensure that industry players can do business without interruption.